It's time to check with our doc, our weekly visit from our doctors from Abington Health Systems. Dr. Andy Starr is from there. He is a specialist on hip replacement and hip surgery. He has given many presentations on orthopedic surgery, including hip resurfacing, new surgical techniques, and hip repair. But we're not going to talk to him about hips today, Doc, because we don't have anybody with a bad hip. But we do have an interesting dynamic, which is the quarterback for the Packers today, Aaron Rodgers, broke his collarbone last year during this season, came back. Quarterback for the Eagles, Nick Foles, has broken his collarbone this year. I guess the first question we have is, was Rodgers' return last year something that was kind of out of the norm?
Well, no. I mean, good morning, guys. He was out about 7 games. So, you know, you figure you break a bone. As long as the bone isn't too badly broken, it's not separated too much. You know, bones heal in about a 6 to 8 week time frame. So, you know, he was pretty much on course of what one would expect with an uncomplicated collarbone fracture.
So is there anything we can draw from his recovery and his success to what Nick Foles is facing now?
Well, you know, we don't have the x-rays. We don't know how bad this fracture was. As long as it's a simple fracture and the bone ends are pretty much together, you know, one would expect that the return would be somewhere in that time frame. A small percentage of these fractures are worse, and they are separated, and then you would probably hear that they were going to operate on him under those circumstances. So we can infer that that's probably not the case.
All right, so if that's not the case, Dr. Starr, what's the process of recovery? How long do you just do nothing, and how do you try to get it back? And between now and 7 weeks, you know, what occurs to get you ready?
Well, you tend to be pretty sore for the first 2 or 3 weeks, and then the fracture becomes what we call sticky. So it starts to heal a little bit, and then it kind of moves as a unit. Now, you wouldn't be able to at that point do anything too strenuous because you could separate it and, you know, make it hurt again. But basically, you're pretty much immobilized for the first few weeks, and then you can start to become more mobile, and they can work on things like range of motion. The problem is, you know, strengthening comes later. And for the typical person that we would see who is not playing professional football, you would just wait it out. And the question always becomes, how good is the person at 7 or 8 weeks? You know, and I think with Aaron Rodgers last year, that was the same question when he was coming back, because there is a risk of re-injuring. The bone isn't quite 100% healed at that point. But it's a gradual process, as with anything, except that in professional sports, you try to get the person back quicker if you can.
Yes, you do. All right, Doc, last question. Who you got today?
Who have I got today? Eagles all the way.
There you go. Thank you. Dr. Andy Starr from Abington Health Systems. Listeners should go to abingtoncheckup.com for more Abington Health information. Doc, have a great rest of your weekend.
You too. Thanks, guys.
Thank you very much, Doctor, for joining us. Not only did Rodgers come back from that injury, but as you said, he has come back to be arguably the best quarterback in the league right now.